nigga move that dope. Young nigga move that dope, baby, move that dope, baby, move that dope.
What's good, y'all? It's Timmy Too Dope. Welcome back to the only hip hop reaction channel on YouTube. Do me a favor though, just don't ask a zookeeper about that, because today I'm gonna give y'all my reaction to Mick Jenkins and his latest project called Elephant in the Room. Mick Jenkins must fuck with this channel and know the amount of songs I like on an album, because this is only 12 songs, short and sweet. Couple features from people that I've never heard of. Allende Cartman is on a track. Someone named Serpent with Feet is on a couple tracks. Someone named Green Slime is on a track. So I'm excited to see how they sound on this album, see how they sound with Mick Jenkins. According to Rap Genius, this is Mick Jenkins' third official studio album. But looking back on his body of work, it's just crazy, man. I've been fucking with him ever since 2013 when he dropped his first mixtape called Trees and Truths. Then the next year, he dropped The Waters, which is probably his most notable mixtape to date. The next year, he dropped Waves, which was crazy. Then 2016, he dropped THC, or The Healing Component, which I guess was his first official studio album. Then he took a couple years off, then released Pieces of a Man, which is his most recent project. And then today, in 2021, he's given us a new project called Elephant in the Room, and I'm real excited to see how it fits in with the rest of these great mixtapes. Only one way to find out. That's to stop talking, get right to reacting. This is Mick Jenkins, Elephant in the Room. First track, The Valley of the Shadow of Death.
We'll break fast, we'll hop in gates, we'll do the same to Pearly. Mistakes add up. Some niggas could name the police. Some niggas always need somebody else's name on the leash. Some of us struggling to find inner peace. I'm still fighting a beast. I show love, I definitely want it requited at least. The eyes stacked again, shorty in the spite as she preach. While I'm smoking my roach, nigga been tree hugging, trying to widen my reach. More by.
You know, the lyrics definitely stand out to me. You know what I'm saying? The lyrics have always been there, but just the conviction that Mick Jenkins says everything with, like, you believe that he believes that shit, you know what I'm saying? So you buy into it more and you pay attention more and shit. What he's saying so far, give a fuck of your pockets low, poverty line, wasn't no avocados, but toast was on me, avocado toast is on me, money. Early would break fast, breakfast was hopping, gates would do the same to the pearly gates when you go to heaven and shit. Mistakes add up. Some niggas can name the police. Like, they've been in the system so much that they know the police by their, you know, first name basis, pretty much. Some niggas always need somebody else name on the lease. Like, you always dependent on somebody else. Some of us struggling to find inner peace. I'm still fighting a beast. I show love. I definitely want it requited at least. I'm pretty sure requited means like, I want it mutually. I want it to be mutual love, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, rapping his ass off so far.
More vitamin E, really trying to widen my scope. They trying to tell me my freedom abides in a boat that died on a boat. It's on that very water. I
damn. Oh my God. That shit died in a boat. Like, when slavery happened and shit, and you fucking, you know, raped us, and you fucking murdered us, and you beat us, and you did all this fucked up shit. The fact that I'm equal, like, that died a long ass time ago, you know what I'm saying?
Cry when I see, but never ask why, cause I know they give a fuck if you fly. We supposed to fly ourselves dope. We supposed to give them the keys so they could get in the dough. Still had to kick in the dough just to get in the dough when he was five. And can't call that boy a thug for the rest of his life. Yeah, yo, I walk through everything they taught me. I ain't tiptoeing, it's too costly. I ain't tiptoeing, it's too costly. Fuck, don't get to see themselves too often.
I kind of dies down a little bit.
Everything around. Fear no evil at all. I pray my closest don't fold. I know somebody gon' fall. But save your face, I can't keep changing pace to stay up with y'all. This ain't a race, see niggas running in place to chase waterfalls. I can relate, I can't erase the times when I drop the ball.
Thanks, man. Thanks, bro. This shit's so, he a goddamn poet, bro. Every fucking line. This might be a long ass review, and if it is, I ain't sorry one bit. You can blame Mick for that one. I fear no evil at all. I pray my closest don't fold. I know somebody gonna fall. Fuck saving face. I can't keep changing pace to stay up with y'all. You know what I'm saying? I can't keep, you know, lowering myself to bring you up. You know what I'm saying? Because sometimes that brings me down and shit. That slows me up. I can't keep falling back so my homies can catch up. You know what I'm saying? I gotta run my own race and look out for me. Then maybe I can circle back and help y'all. You know what I'm saying? This ain't a race. These niggas running in place to chase waterfalls. I can relate. I can't erase the times when I dropped the ball, like just taking accountability and shit. Like, I can't erase that shit. It happened. You know what I'm saying? The only thing I could do is move forward now and shit. This, man, this shit's so poetic. This shit great so far.
You ever had a peace treaty with niggas you still don't fuck with? I started turning my cheek. I had to turn a new leaf on niggas smoking switches. Sweets was on the backwards for some weeks. Then I got straight to the paper. My paper straight as a crease. Got paperweights for receipts. Got label mates. We've been scared by the same man. We don't speak. The neighbors hate.
But literally everything is connecting through this whole fucking thing. What do you want, Mick? Starting with, I had to turn a new leaf. My niggas started smoking Swisher Sweets. Swisher Sweets, obviously, you roll up blunts, you know what I'm saying? Was on them backwoods for some weeks. Is another, you know, tobacco leaf and shit you roll with. Then I got straight to the paper. My paper straight as a crease. Got paperweights for receipts. Receipts, you know what I'm saying? I'm buying stuff, but could obviously mean like, you know, I know some shit about you in the past. I got receipts. I kept tabs on that shit. Got label mates. Labels is also having to do with paper and shit. Label mates have been scamming by the man. We don't speak like that whole thing. Everything connected.
The neighbors say we don't speak. Don't come through preaching. Just practice whatever you was gonna preach. And scratch my back if you reach. Gotta match my joint if you smoking. These niggas that do you like leeches. I'm seeing ghosts like it's bleach. I brought my sand to a fire hydrant. Created a beach. I put my soul in these beats.
I don't like that little clip at the end. I don't like where that shit's going. Oh shit, my bad. Real quick, I fuck with that intro heavy. That was just poetic. Every line tied into the previous line and the next line. Like, this shit was just crazy. Mixed Pen Game is out of this world and underrated, bro. Underrated is an understatement, bro. Real quick, the cover art to this, it kind of looks like to me, have y'all heard the saying, you know, that I got a monkey on my back? You know what I'm saying? Just like pressure on me, basically. It kind of depicts that. I'll put it up, you know, right now when I'm talking about this shit so y'all can see it. First of all, whoever did the art, it kind of looks almost like a Basquiat painting and shit, but that's what I take from it, is there's, you know, a monkey on his back and shit, and I don't know how that ties in with the Elephant in the Room title, but if y'all know, let me know. The second track is called Things You Could Die For If Doing While Black, featuring Ben Hixon. This shit about to be deep, bro.
I just want my weed. I just want my girl. I just wanna smoke my weed. I just wanna love my girl. I just wanna praise my God. I just wanna sell my little cigarettes, nigga. I just wanna do my job.
Oh my God.
Might wanna go for a jog. Might wanna sleep in my car. Might wanna sleep in my bed. Make wanna bear my arms. Make want the police.
This song sounds like it's gonna be exactly what the title says. So far, he's just listing off things that you could die for if doing while black. Go read all these things. You can do this shit while you white, you know what I'm saying? But if your skin darker and shit, it can end up in death, you know what I'm saying?
I just wanna speak my mind. I just wanna post my bill. I ain't even do the crime. I just wanna make mistakes. Might wanna ask a question. Might call the police to protect shit. Might wanna protect myself. I just wanna help.
This shit crazy right now. I'm not giving like a reaction because I'm just taking all this shit in right now, but man, these things, the leash, so to speak, isn't as long when you're black in America, you know what I'm saying? These things, if you're white in America, your leash is extremely long for doing these things. And it's not even, some of these things are literally just everyday things that everybody does. I just want to fuck with my friends, you know what I'm saying? I just want to cross the street, you know what I mean? I ain't even do the crime. I just want to make mistakes. That's the line that hit me. Like, let me just be human. You know what I'm saying? Let me make mistakes and shit. This shit, I ain't even got words for this right now.
I just want to live my life. I just want to live my life.
He said, I just want to live my life. And then a little ad lib, he said, let me stay black and die, man. That's heavy. Ooh, that guitar, bro. Oh my God. That shit was heavy, bro. That shit was simple too. Like, it was so simple and powerful at the same time. You know, he wasn't giving you a complex verse or anything. He was literally just saying a bunch of things that you could die for while doing black in America. You know what I mean? And just off first listen, man, I'm so blown back at the simplicity and the beauty of this song. Not the beauty, you know what I'm saying? Beauty might be the wrong word, but the pain behind it and everything. The art is beautiful. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The inspiration behind the art isn't beautiful at all. Don't get that twisted. But this is definitely, this might pop up in my top 10 songs of the year list at the end of the year. Top 10 verses of the year list at the end of this year. Man, I can go on for days about this song, bro. This shit is amazing. Only other thing I got left to say is RIP to everybody that we've lost at the hands of, you know, crooked cops, racism, all that bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace to y'all. Y'all are missed. Third track, Stiff Arm, featuring Allende Cartman.
I keep tripping over these flows. I keep stiff army too close. Swiss army knife, I keep like seven different type of bros. At least two keep a pole. At least three from the streets. I know five live by the cold. Savages in the fold.
And what about the other two though? What about the other two, Mick? Go mad throwing that up. He said I keep around seven different type of bros. I got two keep a pole, so there's five more left. Three from the streets. That means there's two more homies left. I know five live by the code, so five of those seven live by the... Am I fucked up? Am I missing two people? I want to know what the other two bros do, that's all. Rodney Mullen was like one of the first black skaters to really pop, right? Someone let me know, I'm pretty sure.
That go just weed, too much Tabasco, I'm hot. This shit is ass, bro, all game. Can I dap up? No ops. No. I keep a stiff arm, don't tweet. I ain't the Heisman on beat.
Yeah.
Keep rolling up with your smoke. Fact is, some niggas just weed. Too many hits on this blunt, too many.
Yeah.
Too many words left unsaid. Too many times left on red. Too many times watched you front. Too many.
Hands on my blunt. Hey, this hook is killer, bro. The whole just vibe of this shit, the whole flow of this shit is so laid back. I'm loving this.
Too many people I don't know.
Okay.
Too many hands in my face and my pocket. Shit gets out of pocket. Gotta watch. A few thousand pounds of what the fuck not. Y'all scared we gon' pick up the pace.
I don't know why I'm laughing. I didn't expect that voice. You know what I mean?
A 10 feet tall issue in plain view. Our existence is the elephant in every boardroom.
Is this supposed to be like the new, God damn it, what's his name? Big Rube? Is that what I'm thinking of from, God damn it, I gotta look this shit up. Is that what his name is? Yeah, it's Big Rube, the southern rapper, I guess you can call him and shit, but he always giving kind of like spoken word, intros, outros and shit. He kind of remind me of like a newer version of that. I think they're newer.
Thick skin, but a sensitive touch, can't shrink, don't mean it, don't hurt. Enormity is a gift and a curse. We gon' wait for recognition, or flip the conference table first. Their fear of ours, ain't no telling what's worse.
Damn. Allende Cartman gave me a lot in that outro to digest and to have to break down. I'm definitely gonna have to listen to that multiple times. That definitely sounded like some deep shit, you know what I'm saying? But this whole track, man, Mick, the vibe of this track, the flow on this was just so laid back, but he was still talking his shit, you know what I mean? The fourth track he released as a single, it's got a music video with it as well. The fourth track, Contacts. No More Heroes, is that Mick starting his own label or something? Oh, Caught a Body. Oh shit.
Tell you how I feel inside. ain't chill enough. I'm coming from the illest side.
Don't feel enough.
Fuck what niggas think of that. The socks is pink, the ink is black. The grass is green, the link is broke.
I love how he talks about such like weird shit. He just said, what, the salt is pink? Like, pink Himalayan pink salt. You know what I'm saying? I got some in my cupboard right now. But what other rapper you know talking about pink salt and making it fly? Also, that kind of goes back to the beginning of this track where he's saying, talk about how I feel. That's not trill enough. That's not drill enough. You know what I'm saying? Talking about my emotions isn't cool as a rapper. You know what I'm saying? But Mick makes it fly as fuck.
Flowing like the sink is broken, dripping so consistent now. Watch them grow complicit. Oh, you flipping now? Shit hit different. I need scissors now. Cut it.
Yo, he's so dope how he sets up these punchlines and shit. You almost see him coming, you know what I'm saying? But it's just like, how is he gonna get there? You know what I mean? He said, hit different, and I was like, okay, a scissor bar is coming. Then he says something about, pass me the scissors. All right, I need a scissor. You know what I'm saying? Then he had a line before that and shit that was crazy. Hold up.
The trip is so consistent, ink is broke. Flowing like the sink is broke, the drip is so consistent.
Flowing like the sink is broke, the flow is so consistent, or the drip is so consistent. You know what I'm saying? That's another one where I was like, okay, sink, but like, what's he gonna do with this? You know what I'm saying? I would put Mick Jenkins against anybody as far as pen game goes right now.
Tape and faded with no clippers, don't ask, no Kawhi. Turnstone cold, you get the fucking with my mobile wise.
See what the fuck I'm talking about, bro. He said something about Stone Cold, and I was like, all right, what's it gonna be? Something about stunting, stunner, you know what I'm saying? Tied it in with the beer and shit, man. Mick too nice with it.
I was right, I was 63rd, you know the vibes. Archetypes and prototypes, I know those guys. Press me, I could go get my shit notarized. Instantly, no Polaroids. Instantly, I'm Jonah, y'all gonna have to throw me overboard.
Did this man just kill himself and kidnap himself and got himself in the trunk while he's driving and eating chips and shit? What kind of Texas Chainsaw Massacre shit is this?
When is y'all niggas gonna realize? Realize, huh?
Okay. Alright, it was dope back then, like when Pac said it, you know what I'm saying? But like, it's been memed to death, so every time I think of that, I'm just like, okay, I've seen that on Facebook, you know what I'm saying? But the origins of what the realize is dope, you know what I'm saying?
Trying to be more James, I walk in Peter's shoes. Sparrows gotta be my views. Vincent frames I seen through. Fear God, I'm stepping in, no weapon form. The needle moves, the record scratch, the blessings pour. Almost like I'm pre-approved for everything. Good, my check is strong.
My God, bro, he too good with this shit, bro. Holy shit.
I seen through. Fear God, I'm stepping in, no weapon form. The needle moves, the record scratch, the blessings pour. Almost like I'm pre-approved for everything. My credit good, my check is strong. My breakfast good, I'm shredded wheat. The hairs is gone, I'm back and forth. Trying to get my point across. Olympic preparations, all these habits form. Elevated patterns, I can take some PA's balance off. Win against the way, but I'm no Hasselhoff. Ain't no more low key, I took the silence off. Old school, but the mileage new. Seen it from the pilot's view. Gotta be more hands on.
Man, you know, I'm supposed to be stopping it, breaking this shit down or whatever, but I'm just taking in the clinic that he's putting on as far as just rapping ability right now. This is why I'm a fan of Mick.
Trying to be more James, I walk in Peter's shoes. Sparrows gotta be my views. Vince's friends, I see him through.
Here we go. Mick taking Mick out. This Mick on Mick violence has got to stop, ladies and gentlemen. that was a dope little music video and shit, but obviously the real star of the show was that song, was that verse, those verses, that hook. That whole thing was just crazy, bro. And so far, four tracks deep, that's my favorite one by far. Fifth track, Scottie Pippen featuring Serpent with Feet.
I was definitely tripping on it, I think about number two, I was tripping. And when I had a shoulder, I never would have. On my own, with without you.
Serpent with Feet low key sound like Mick Jenkins. I'm starting to think maybe it's an alter ego or something. It kind of sounds like him, but then again, it kind of doesn't. You know what I mean?
I was just used to that shit. Some suicides after practice. I was conditioned this way. You a brand new conditioner. I didn't realize that I was auditioning, no. That's randomized, that way more intentional now. That's all the way down to your hips in the distance. They sway. I got the mirage, you're kissing the lip gloss you use. I got the wrinkles and all of the dips in your face.
Hey, Mick always bringing the sexy shit, bro. No. No homo. We still saying that in 2021, or are we just comfortable with ourselves and shit? Yo, Mick Jenkins always on that, like, that smooth type, you know, seduction type shit, and just being great with words and being a wordsmith and shit. He paints that picture beautifully, you know what I mean? Starting out the verse, I was just used to that shit. It's like suicides after practice. I was conditioned that way. Suicides are like a conditioning drill. You start at the baseline, go to the next line, baseline, free throw line, baseline, 3-point line, baseline, half court. It's just a way of getting in shape for the game and shit. Less randomized and way more intentional now. Like, I'm not just doing shit for the sake of doing shit. Like, I'm doing it with purpose. You know what I mean? And then saying, I definitely memorized your kiss and the lip gloss you use. I counted the freckles and all the dips in your face. Like, that imagery is just crazy, man. I feel like a lot of people, myself included, can relate to and, you know, imagine those lines.
No matter how hard I shoot, I would never win it all.
Shit, crazy.
That isn't likely these days. You know what I mean? We sacrifice for this love. I know for sure it's not overpriced over here. And that's not to say it wasn't expensive as fuck. That's not to say we didn't roll the dice over here. Admitted to me, despite the advice we heard, we thought it was speed as well, but wise over here. Felt like a Melbourne of paradise for a year. Still, we throwing rice over here. We both had walls up so high. We seen new heights over here.
We are 5 tracks in, and we don't have just 5 good songs, 5 hits, you know what I'm saying? We got 5 top shelf songs right off the rip. These songs are some of the best songs that I've heard this year, man. Just from production, from the mix in this is great, the content in it, the way he's delivering that shit, the vocals, the harmonies, everything, man. This song had everything, smooth as fuck. You can put it on to set the mood. You can put it on I don't know, man. Just put this shit on, bro. 6 track, Gucci Try to Tell Me.
Lost in the sauce. And that sauce is yours, I know. Got no facade. I can't change the course.
Oh, man.
I can't get lost.
Talk to me,
bro. If we lose this vibe, no Randy Moss. But I'll catch your feels one thing.
Bro, this dude, Mick Jenkins, is so damn versatile, and he's so different. There's not a lot of rappers, really any, that are doing the rap jazz type thing like Mick Jenkins is doing it. And if there is, they're not doing it as well as Mick Jenkins is doing it. This jazz rap type fusion and shit that he's been developing, you know what I'm saying? It might be in its final form right now, man, because that hook was jazzy as fuck. That hook was great.
Bumpelli may I see us booed up. She stole my soul, must be in blue suede shoes. I'm in her Kool-Aid. She got the juice, I call her Cool G. Don't leave the crib, we catching blue rays. Blending well, we sip the smoothie. It's just a Tuesday. Won't hesitate.
Hey, hold up. He getting in his bag. He flowing his ass off. But I got to stop you there just to ask a question. Mick, don't leave the crib. We watching Blu-rays? You still watching Blu-rays, bro? You don't know about a Fire Stick? You don't know about Google? What's that shit? Google got a stick, you put it in the thing. You can rent this shit off Xbox, you know what I'm saying? We living in 2021 is what I'm trying to say.
Lost in the sauce.
That sauce is yours. I love a dip. I should have been on this. 6-4-6. 7th track, DUI, featuring Green Slime.
Influence. Niggas want me on the board now. Trust me. Just in case they can't employ you, they'll nudge me.
Very interesting hook. I'm interested to see where this goes.
I hear him talking, but I ain't concerned. Nigga, this patience. The streets teach you how to wait your turn. What you in a hurry for? Death around the corner, and they sell that shit at the corner store.
25,
nigga, fucking $3.99. Hold on a flight, high fleet from.
Okay, I'm liking Green Slime so far. It said the streets teaching you to wait your turn. What you in a hurry for? Death right around the corner, and they sell that shit at the corner store. 2 for $5, nigga. Fuck it. $3.99. You know what I'm saying? You can get this death absolutely free.
Connections I don't want, they telling me I need. They need me to say, or may need me to see, or may need me to tweet. And I may need to fuck, say what I mean on these beats. Y'all need in between. Y'all marvel at these flows. We keeping them clean. We keeping it authentic. Who need to be screened? Who really the fam? Who really here to see and be seen?
Okay, big props to Mick Jenkins for just being different on these songs and being different on these hooks, trying different things, you know what I mean? That was probably the weakest song on this album so far, but that's really saying something, you know what I mean? Because all the tracks before this have been great. Top shelf, like I said, some of the best songs that I've heard this year, honestly. This wasn't that, you know what I'm saying? Green Slime was dope in his own right. Mick came and did his thing. This kind of just sounded like a cautionary tale almost about who you keep around you, who you influence directly, who influences you, you know what I'm saying? There's that saying, guilty by association, so it's kind of touching on that, I feel like. But a dope track, but just not as good as the other ones. 8-track, Speed Racer. Look, if this doesn't sample the show Speed Racer, I'm gonna be really disappointed.
Go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go.
We haven't kicked it in a while. I've been so low key, we ain't got lifted in a while. Chasing after big paper, things got different after a while. Trying to match your speed, we can't catch up. I'm skipping rides that I split, used to be my stepping stones. I'm stepping like I'm on ice, none of my lessons clung. Please do not hate me cause you less informed. Thought it was one of those no weapon form situations. Caught implications of other, that's why I'm on your line. It's not as simple as you make time for what you make time. You know me well if we face time. We haven't kicked it in a while.
Hey, I feel that at the end, you know me well if we FaceTime. Like, I do not like talking on the phone, let alone FaceTime. So if I FaceTime you, I fuck with you the long way. You know what I mean? A couple dope lines back in this verse. I'm skipping rocks that I swear used to be my stepping stones. Like, those stepping stones, obviously big to support your weight and shit. You know what I mean? I'm skipping rocks that used to be my stepping stones. Like, those big stepping stones, they're in my hand now. And I'm just skipping those motherfuckers, bro. It's nothing to me now. Yeah, that was a vibey ass song, man. I hate using that word, but that's just what it was. You know what I'm saying? Talking about a girl who he hasn't kicked it with in a minute, and they playing catch up, hence the Speed Racer title. You know what I'm saying? Dope shit still. 9th track is a track called Truffles. It's got a music video with it, but I've already done a reaction to that. I'm going to try to remember to leave a link in the description down below. If you look there and it's not there, remind me in the comments. But I'm going to go ahead and just listen to it. I'm not going to put the music video up, but I'm going to go ahead and listen to it, see how it fits within the album. Number 9, Truffles.
Yeah, throw another young nigga making trouble. Yeah, young nigga making trouble. Young nigga making trouble. Got paid night eating in the chef kitchen. He don't want the truffle. Trees funky than the truffle. Think they want me in the muscle. Oh hell nah, here's another nigga making shit like the hoe. This nigga speaking his mind. This nigga shitting like mine.
Track 10 called Is This a Cigarette? No. Is this, no, that was way too, that was too loud. That wasn't the one. Is this a cigarette? No. Is this a cigarette? Yeah, that was the one. That was the one right there.
Honestly, I doubt it if I only seen it on the internet.
Facts.
A lot of niggas bread, not a lot of niggas starve, bread. Hottest thing that I love gon' for me is this cigarette.
Damn. This motherfucker is so poetic, bro. It's the concept of, is this a cigarette? You know what I'm saying? The concept of, how do you bring it? how is this thing that I love going to kill me? You know what I'm saying? It's an addiction. I'm assuming he's going to be talking about a relationship with a woman or just some sort of relationship. You know what I'm saying? That is similar to that relationship with cigarettes. You know what I'm saying? What I love is going to kill me. You know what I'm saying? Crazy.
We got bigger fish to feel like we ain't laying up. Dunking that shit from the free throw, niggas fucking hacks. Got the simulation glitching, bitch, we busting back. Brought water to drink, brought water to gargle with it. It was salt water, most at the surface on some snorkel shit. I'm in the dark water, it's black and white, just like the orcas is. Killing shit, Darth Vader, even with the force, these niggas forcing it. Art paid us, even with the failure.
Again, just every line tying into the next line of shit. Also, I feel like this is the first song that he's mentioned water in this whole album. You know what I'm saying? I'm probably missed a few lines where he's mentioning shit, but this is the first one that came to my attention and shit. But then he just doesn't just go to the surface with it, no pun intended. Brought water to drink, brought water to gargle with. If this was the salt water, most at the surface on some snorkel shit, you know what I'm saying? The salt water, they got the fucking snorkels in the ocean and shit. I'm in the dark water, it's black and white, like I'm deep in it. It's black and white, just like orcas is, the dolphins, orcas, you know what I'm saying? Killing shit. Darth Vader, even with the force, these niggas forcing it, like that all ties in and shit.
The chain smoking, no change, just shorty namesake. I've been lane switching, I ain't switching the frame rate. Iron Chef cooking, you can't stay in the same kitchen, whipping left handed. My aim steady, I can't sway. Bass clef branded, they know that I keep it low key. Apex legend, I can't stress it enough though. Nigga born from pain. Remember when I would hit purple for that quarter thing? You got that bullshit off my shoulders like a halter top.
I feel like there's something I'm missing with the Apex Legend bar, but the line before bass clap branded, they know that I keep it low key. Bass note is a note, and like when you're reading music and shit. Apex Legend, I can't stress it enough though. Nigga born from pain, I remember when I hit the perp up for the quarter thing. Get that bullshit off my shoulders like a halter top. You know what I'm saying? I'm still trying to figure out how this ties into the hook. You know what I'm saying? How is this thing that I love gonna kill me? Still trying to figure out what exactly he was talking about or who he's talking about. If y'all know, let me know. Yeah, if I had to guess, make an educated guess what he's talking about, the line before he's talking about the thing that I love gonna kill me. He said, you know, honestly, I doubt it if I only seen it on the internet. A lot of niggas bred, but not a lot of niggas thoroughbred. How is this thing that I love gonna kill me? Is this cigarettes? I'm thinking he's maybe talking about social media. You know what I'm saying? How is this thing that I love gonna kill me? This thing, and it's very addictive, just as you know, nicotine as cigarettes are. You know what I'm saying? A lot of niggas bred, not a lot of niggas thoroughbred. People be fronting all the time on the internet. You know what I'm saying? And a couple lines throughout his verses and stuff kind of make me kind of reinforce that thought for me. But yeah, that's just my opinion. That's just what I took from it. Let's move on to the 11th track, Reflection.
Put a mirror in a nigga face and he'll run. Tell him that you love him, he may pull out his gun.
Damn.
Look just like me, even down to the walk. Notice the difference probably soon as we talk.
Oh, this song will be like that, Mick. Okay. Put a mirror in a nigga face and he'll run. Like he can't face himself. Tell him that you love him, he might pull out his gun, bro. Some people don't know how to act when they're shown love. They're not used to that shit. So they just act, you know, and they, you know, push that shit away, you know what I'm saying, and reject that type of love. And he's saying in this case, you tell him that you love him, he might pull out his gun. Like, he might react like that. That is crazy imagery, Mick.
Donovan Mitchell, I'm definitely finna talk all this jazz.
Facts.
Constantly victim, I'm more than kinda hip to the blues. That's why I could give a shit about the news. And still, despite me consciously victim, these niggas like the strippers of truth. Large contradictions, I'm 6'5", trying to fit in the coop. Large contributions to culture, and somewhere someone sitting in cubes didn't approve. Ooh. Ice cubes in my reasoning, you should know that.
I had to pause it for that bar, man. Large contributions to culture, and somewhere, someone sitting in cubes didn't approve. You know what I'm saying? I'm contributing to the culture. I'm doing all this shit musically and otherwise, you know what I'm saying, to improve the culture that I love so much. And somewhere, someone sitting in cubes doesn't approve of that shit, doesn't approve of a move I made. You know what I'm saying? Someone that knows nothing about hip-hop, knows nothing about the culture, some suit and tie motherfucker, and that ultimately makes the calls and shit didn't approve of, you know, him hopping on a song or doing whatever and shit.
I window shopped it, then I copped it, now I got it on. And I know everything that came before that dotted line these days. Held the mirror to my face.
Who you think you talking to, huh?
I didn't run away, I ran in place.
Okay.
Put a mirror in a nigga.
I like that flip on the initial hook, the way he ended that verse. He's saying, held a mirror to my face, I didn't run away. I ran in place, you know what I'm saying? I kept looking at that mirror. I didn't ran away. I know who I am. I'm comfortable looking in the mirror at who I am, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just sitting here running in place.
We only talk about ball. We only talk once a year. Not even that, I don't call. I haven't called in like 3. He's 6'2", I'm 6'5". He used to make me feel small. I used to think he was strong. Now I know he's just weak. Got me climbing a mountain and saw cliffs and no peaks. I would slide hydroplane.
This shit sound personal, man. This sound like a close homie, you know what I'm saying, that he grew up with. We only talk about ball. We only talk once a year. Not even that, I don't call. I haven't called in like 3 weeks. He's 6'2", I'm 6'5", he's trying to make me feel small. I used to think he was strong, now I know that he weak. So I guess reading that, maybe they weren't too close or whatever, maybe it was just kind of an acquaintance and shit, but this shit definitely sound personal.
Used to say that with tears, he only heard with his ears, we speak with more than our lips. I showed us Pringle enough chips, I ain't gonna make it upset. One day I didn't get upset, some shit just is what it is. I'm way too deep with the script, it's paralyzing in fact. Analyzing the facts, calculating the trauma that iterated on wax. Man, if it wasn't for rap, this shit a mirror of sorts. Got me seeing myself.
Yo, Mick getting his shit off right now, bro. I had to stop it just for copyrights and shit. Don't at me or do. Man, yeah, this shit is just crazy, man. But the line I wanted to stop it for, it's paralyzing the facts, the analyzing the facts, calculating the trauma to iterate it on wax. So he could be talking about calculating the trauma, labels making money off of their trauma, or it could be calculating the trauma to iterate it on wax, to put all this shit that's happened to me in life into verses and make it musical to iterate it on wax, to wax, I mean, CDs, you know what I'm saying? You know, taking all this shit that I lived through and shit and putting it into music form, basically. Yeah, that's some dope shit.
Put a mirror in a nigga face and he'll run. Tell him that you love him, he may pull out his gun.
Y'all need to respect Mick Jenkins, bro. If y'all didn't before, after this album so far, y'all need to respect this man, bro. And he needs to get his flowers, his admiration, his love. He needs to get on a higher pedestal, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if that's a cosign, signing to somebody with more notoriety to give him a platform, but bro, more people need to know about Mick Jenkins, bro. Last song on this album, Rug Burn, featuring Serpent with Feet.
Niggas sleep on the floor, like they cousins stayed over the weekend. Real niggas know.
Facts.
Real bitches quote.
And that shit was the best times as a kid, bro. I wish I could go back to that shit. There's sleepovers, playing Madden 08, truck sticking motherfuckers, bro. Burning hot dogs, overseasoned hot dogs in the motherfucking oven and shit. Making city punch and sugar and water, you know what I'm saying? Doing hood rat shit, being kids, you know what I'm saying? That was the shit, bro.
But all my real niggas know. Yeah, my real niggas know. When they see me, they live. They be like, make you top 5. I be like, nigga, I know.
Huh, facts.
I like to keep it a buck. I used to keep it like 80. I hope you feeling my growth. Niggas sleep on the floor and don't smell the feet in they face. One by the head and the toes.
Damn.
Sweat for the bread with no yeast. I had the croissants and sweets. Seen niggas beg for the dough. Seen mamas need the whole wheat. Seen butter melt on the biscuit as father's hair for the dough. I got the bread when he loaf. Finna bust at the sky and make sure they hear if they woke. I know the real ones a quote. I know my real niggas know.
Talk to him, man.
Niggas sleep on the floor like, can I just crash at your crib for a few? Got nowhere to go.
Smooth ass way to end an amazing album. This had no skips, man. This was a great, solid project. 12 songs, which to me is perfect, right in that sweet spot. You get me anywhere from like 8 to 14 songs, I'm a happy man, you know what I mean? And all these songs were quality, all these songs were different. The production was amazing, the mixing was amazing, the lyrics amazing, the flows amazing, just the artistry, everything about this was great. And I feel like it's one of those albums that's just gonna get better the more I listen to it, you know what I mean? And I wouldn't be surprised if this pops up on my top 10 albums of the year list at the end of the year. Only time will tell. Definitely top shelf in the dope scale, ain't no doubt about that. If it's one thing that I can take from this album, is that y'all need to start putting some respect on Mick Jenkins' name, man. All the albums that I went through in the intro, Trees and Truths, The Waters, Waves, THC, the Pieces of a Man, and now you add this to the list, he's got one of the best bodies of work in hip-hop right now, hands down in my opinion. That's all I got for today's video. If you're new to the channel, make sure you hit that sub to show some love. Trying to make it to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. So if you're watching this right now and you're not yet subscribed, make sure you help me get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year by hitting that red subscribe button right down below. Hit that like button to continue to support the channel. Share this video with your friends. Let them know there's some light-skinned dude over on YouTube reacting to Mick Jenkins albums. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite track from this amazing album was. Talk to me. You know I talk back. I've been Timmy. Y'all been too dope. Till next time. Peace.